Hi, Edward Hayden here. Today I'm going to showcase the Carrigdon Eclectic range and I'm going to make a gorgeous, lovely breakfast option for you. So what I've got is I've got some of the lovely thick buttermilk pancakes and I'm going to serve those with a gorgeous berry compote. So perfect for those long, lazy weekend breakfasts. The recipe is very simple, so I'm going to get down to business straight away. So what I've got is I've just got some flour, so just a little bit of plain flour. I'm going to sieve that into my bowl here. To that, I'm going to add in just a little bit of sugar. Now again, you can really adjust the recipe to suit your own tastes in terms of the sugar content, but just a little bit of sugar is nice to sweeten them. Then I've got two eggs, so I've got two lovely fresh eggs. I'm going to pop those in there, just like so. And then to conclude the batter, I'm just going to add in some buttermilk. Now there's lots of different types of pancakes. There's obviously the thin French crepes. These ones that I'm doing are kind of almost like the American thick pancakes or the Irish drop scones. So pop in the milk. What I tend to do is just put in a little bit of the milk first, just to achieve the right consistency. Sometimes it's easier to get the lumps out of it with a smaller amount of milk. So just put in the smaller amount of milk first, and then you can kind of just robustly mix this to kind of get any of the lumps out of that, and then you can correct the consistency with the remaining batter. So that's basically our lovely batter. I'll just show you the consistency of that. It's really, really nice consistency, just like so, okay? If you wanted, you could put in some of the lovely blueberries. I've got some gorgeous blueberries here that I'm going to make a berry compote with, but you could put the blueberries into the actual batter or put a bit of lemon zest into the batter, maybe some ground cinnamon as well. So lots of options of versatility with the batter. So I'm going to leave it rest just for a minute or two. Now the berry compote is really, really simple, but really, really tasty. This can be used for lots of different things, whether it's maybe for some ice cream, obviously some of the pancakes, or just to serve with a lovely kind of a meringue or a pavlova or something. It's absolutely divine. So what I've got is I've just got a little selection of berries here. So I'm using just some fresh raspberries. I'm also going to use some fresh blueberries in there as well. And I'm just going to put a few strawberries. So if I just take my strawberries, I'm literally just going to cut the little stalk off the top of the washed strawberries. And I'm just going to slice those in about 3 or 4 slices. Now, obviously you can use frozen berries for this, but the fresh berries are just so gorgeous at the minute that they'll work really, really nicely for you. So that should be sufficient there. Pop in the berries, and then into that I'm just going to add a little bit of water. So I've just got a couple of tablespoons of water that I'm going to add in there. Now again, if you didn't want to use the water, what's lovely in there is the juice of half an orange, and that just gives a gorgeous flavor. And again, I'm just going to put in a wee little bit of sugar in there as well, again to taste, so vary it to suit your own taste preferences. I'm going to pop that onto the stove, and that will cook very, very quickly. Basically what I'm looking for is just for that to come to the boil, and the berries will just poach out very simply and very gently in that. That berry compote will last in your fridge for about 4 or 5 days, so really, really delicious, just to kind of give you that sweet treat whenever you're looking for it. Now, meanwhile then, I've got my pan on here, so I've just put a little bit of oil. You can cook your pancakes in either oil or butter. I just think they end up, the kind of the thicker pancakes cook a little bit better in the oil. So here I've got my pancake batter. So using either a ladle or a spoon, I'm just going to spoon amounts of this batter onto the pan. So we'll just give the pan a little second or two to heat up. In the meantime, you can see that already my berries are starting to boil, and I don't want these to be cooked within an inch of their life, and that's so important, because when you're using such really good quality ingredients like these fresh berries, you want them to still stay in their own piece, but just to have softened down a little bit. So don't cook them too aggressively. So I'm just going to reduce the heat of that and allow those to cook for just another moment or two. Meanwhile then, we're going to just take some of this lovely batter, and I'm just going to put spoonfuls of that out onto our pan. Now again, if you were making, as I said to you, those French crepes, you'd be putting on a much thinner batter. But with these pancakes, you can see that they'll hold their shape. They'll hold their own shape really, really well. What I will say to you is you just need to be careful not to undercook them, because if you cook them too quickly, because of that little bit thicker, they can be like undercooked and doughy in the center. So you need to make sure that they're light and fluffy. The buttermilk will work very favorably for you as a lovely rising agent. So that will help them to kind of to rise and swell, but just cook them really nicely. Now I've got a gorgeous platter here that I'm going to serve those on, and I'm going to serve those in just a second. Now look at the lovely consistency of our berry compote. Isn't that absolutely gorgeous? Oh, there's such like an ambrosial smell off of that. It's really, really beautiful. So I'm just going to cook that for another minute or so. And then you can see the pancakes. Just have a little look at the pancakes here. You can see that they're just starting to bubble up really, really nicely. And then when you think that we're ready to turn them, and I think we should be happy enough now, they're just starting to bubble. So just allow them to cook then on the other side, and literally another minute or so for those, and they're going to be ready to go, and we'll serve those up onto our platter. Now the thing about these is, if you're doing these for the lovely weekend breakfast, be very careful, because you can find yourself ending up at the stove top for the morning, because much wants more when it comes to these glorious pancakes. So people are really going to want to get a good taste of them and a good sense. Just look at them now to see that lovely sense of a rise that they're getting. They're rising so beautifully and they're swelling so beautifully. Obviously they need to be eaten straight away, so you need to make sure that all of your guests are at the table or maybe out in the garden ready to dig into these straight away. I'm going to just serve a little few fresh berries on the side of these as well, and I think we all eat with our eyes, so I've just got some lovely flowers. I've got some edible violas here, and I'm just going to use the violas to garnish the top of that as well. So pancakes just about ready here. Lovely. Just about ready to serve those up. Okay, and there we have it. So there's our lovely pancakes, and stack those up really nicely onto your platter. Just kind of put them at a little angle, just like so. And then I've got some of this gorgeous berry compote. Now this can be served both hot and cold, so you can serve this either hot or cold. Some of that beautiful compote, just like so. And just let that all spill down really nicely onto your pancakes. Okay, then as I said, a few more little fresh berries can be popped onto there, just to make that look really, really nice. And then I have a little bit of icing sugar here and a few little edible violas as well. So there you have it. Nice, very quick and simple recipe, and really, really tasty, nice breakfast to be served.